Kollel, as the Rosh Kollel said, is located in Marlborough, New Jersey. And we thank Rabbi Aretz and Rabbi Gortz for their being gracious, very, very gracious hosts. But being a Hebrew community, they didn't have many Sfarim that were in Hebrew. So before the Kollel started, besides providing the basic Sfarim we'd be using daily, the Rosh Kollel invested in a computer and a printer with Mitzra Chochma. Mitzra Chochma is a computer program containing tens of thousands of Sfarim that you can look up what you need. But the Rosh Kollel obtained something much better than Mitzra Chochma. Rav Shmuel Goldstein and Ron Baron, together with the Rosh Kollel, complete the Kollel and all. I can speak for myself as well as many others. This is besides what we gain every day in the base measures. When I want to know a halacha, I can call or text Rav Shmuel, and I'll get a response with the halacha, and he also gives me the time for an explanation when that's necessary. And when I want to know where a certain gemara is, I ask Rav Avram. And then I don't need to know the exact word you need for Yitzhak Chochma to search. He tells me where it is. Now together these three make up a trio whose bekiyas and halacha is preceded by their havana and the sugya, as well as a tremendous clarity from all three of them in Hashgah. Now Rav Shmuel, Rav Avram, the Rosh Kollel as well, and some of the Yigalit are Talmidim of the Yeshiva of Staten Island. This means that the Rosh Yeshiva, Rabbi Reuven Feinstein shlita, is mentioned by someone nearly every day. Through this, I've gotten to know some of the Rosh Yeshiva's psakim, hashkafas, Derech HaChaim, and some Sipuri tzaddikim as well. And I can say I've become a bit of a chassid of the Rosh Yeshiva. It is the Kollel's chus to have the Rosh Yeshiva as our Meir Derech, as well as to have him here today. So before the presentation of the smithas, we would like to ask the Rosh Yeshiva shlita to give some divrei bracha.
First of all, mazel tov to everybody. Thank you. The ones who actually reached the Madrega personally, and the ones who see them, the children reaching the Madrega. That's important. The yeshivish years that taught you to be mavdil, every chilik, stuff like that. Some of them you got good, some of them were bad, chilukim. But to learn it, now it's going to be the nice. Now you got to be right. And we see this chilik, Zayin Parshas Shemini, Zayin Parshas Kedoshim, that because the Benish was mavdil, therefore we have a chilik to be mavdil. Therefore we have no different in that. Shochet, around 50 on 50, which is trey, 15 plus a mashiru, which is kosher. So we really are splitting hairs, but it's not a hair splitting thing. It's not like the going thing. Make a spray, taste a cup, you make a thing, you make a different thing. Good or bad. It's not such a thing. There's a line. If you learn the Chaim's to understand that a lot of comes for the Gedachim, that it's a big Mizrachal Ma'ilov. It seems like a Mashu, but it's Mizrachal Ma'ilov. And the very important issues that come up, we see a funny thing. Like the Lechem HaPonim has to be made of Tefach thick, which we don't make any matzah, the Tefach thick, that's why the borderline chametz. Maybe we make papers, we make oil, and has to make warm water. We make matzah, very thin, that's what, less than probably an eighth of an inch, probably. And it has this Mayim Shalonu, and no mepeches, right? And yet the Torah, to reach the epitome, what the Beishim wants, I want you on that borderline. I want you to be able to be machin and to understand that this is kosher, this is holy, this is not. And we can try and protect ourselves, if you say, because unfortunately we don't know, we're not that good, so in the normal living that we do, we try to stay away as far as we can and make thin knots with cold water, and we know may pay us. But that's not the way that the Rebbeinu wanted. In time of Beis HaMikdash, Kehanim was risen, and so we used to make milchik matzahs with milk and everything else, because it takes risas to do it. And that's what the Rebbeinu really wants from us. He wants his risas. And it's also to understand our chiyuvim. Sometimes we don't understand, we don't even understand what's taking place in front of us. When I became 20, I asked him what to work on. He told me, keep it in. He says, why? Because people are used to treating them like a shifter. Like, you know, it's mom made me this, mom made me that, mom give me this, whatever the question is. And the Mashiach says, you're not even allowed to, you're not allowed to ask a parent to do something for you. I would say, you can't ask them. And means you don't have to stand up for me. You don't have to give me food if I don't want my food. I have to give you. That's awesome. And there's no excuse for it. So I was about to do it. So there we have to learn the difference between what's called a boss, an owner, not a boss, and a servant. It's a big difference. And that's again the Torah tells us that. If you, for my people, Rashi says, Shabbi, so then all of a sudden you're going to be a different type of person. If you're not, you're going to be Luchadnezzar Chaberev. In other words, you're made to serve. You're going to serve humanity one way or the other. So if you're going to be my people, you're going to serve humanity that way. You're not going to be serving humanity. Yosef was an Eved. I mean, he may have a nice job. Daniel was an Eved. But then they belong to a different society, different ideas and concepts. And that's one thing that's very important to us to understand. What we even see, that it should look, that one is a host, and one is an Eved. It's a big difference between the two. And understanding HaKadosh Baruch Hu, what we are, Admus, I mean the echoed of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the singularity, what does that mean? He's one. You know, we believe in monotheism. What does that mean? We have an interesting Avtera that we didn't read it this year, because we had Tazria and Tzera together. The Avtera of Tazria, we have a story with Nana. He was sent. The little girl that he captured told him, if you want to get cured, go to the Navi in Shemin. So he comes, and he goes to his Melech Harom, and he sends gifts, and he told the Melech Yisrael, cure my Eved. And he goes to see Elisha. Elisha is the Navi. And Elisha doesn't even bother coming out of that house. He just sends out a message. Then I want you to go table yourself 7 times in the outing, and you'll be cured completely. And he gets very upset. He wanted and felt that there should be an act of some sort. Put your hand on my body, look up to God, to pull your hand off slowly, and the whole tzaddas follows it, your hand there. It's a good act, it's a good show. That I would understand. But boy, you're telling me you want to go dip in the water. What's water got to do with curing tzaddas? I have better rivers in Narom, in Gameset. Why do I need this thing? But he asked him, the soldier said, oh, what is going to cost you? Big deal. You shall take a bath in the alley. And he said, he doesn't. And he's cured. And all of a sudden, he marches back to Elisha. And he says, Ati Dati, now I know, Kierin. Elikim b'chol ha'aretz, there are no gods in the whole land, in the world. Hakim Yisrael, only by the Jews. What did he see that made him some such impression on him that he understands there's only one concept of God? And you want to time it means that because it's so partial, if you live with him, that's true, that may be a big part of it. But I think it's simple that he understood that it's not important that you show up. The Navi has the power because God controls everything in the world. That has Soviet of a God that controls everything. Why? There's no two in the world for some reason. There's no room for two. God is infinite. There's no way to put a second God. So therefore there's only one. Not because God has, he's the one that does everything, but put a second one in here. And therefore this is the whole idea that we can understand that if you have that there's one God that controls everything, then that's a concept of God. Anything that can do this, infuriates for war, this is for love, this is for anger, this is for this, that's not a God. That's what he understood. And these are the things that we have to chazer in ourselves, be able to give over to other people, that there's an Indian of a hevdel to understand that difference. Besides that, once you become a Rebbe, a Rebbe, you can start to mashpi on people. You're going to have to get to the part of the Rashi, Pasuk Kosei. Like the Pasuk Kosei says in Kosei, the Leicha, this is very distant. That's the Pasuk. It says, Rashi, Yochel, you would think, it means Kiyama Mitzvah. It says, Tishmeru. So it says already Kiyama Mitzvah. So therefore, what is the Pasuk talking about? That it should be, what do you call, Ramil Matera. It doesn't make any sense. It should have said the last word. It said Vasisimu. What are you telling me, Tishmeru? Since they say Tishmeru. That's only learning. But the Torah wants us that we shouldn't have to go through the Mishnah Sachayim. We should be able to, like it says in Parshas, what he calls him. The Pshat is that my word should be like Yisidur Alideshe, Yivin Malayesa. In other words, you don't have to go through the troubles of life to make you sure about Tochet. I lost my money. And nobody else, and I still believe in God. That's a tough, job to do that. But the lesson, if you learn it and be basic in it, that will give you like you see in Alidesha, in the Alidesha. That's putting into that keach. How do we imagine it? Because when we learn it and we imagine the situation that we're talking about, then obviously we're living through it. And they're living through it that we don't have to do more than that. And that's the law of this. So then when you live through mitzvahs, you become the mitzvah. That's the asisim of some. Doesn't mean you have to actually do the mitzvah. But you yourself became so perfected by learning that the mitzvah is going to be an obvious thing when you get to do it. If it comes to God, it doesn't come, it doesn't come. You already know the kind. It's not necessary to prove it. The only reason you need to have a mitzvah is to actually my seis is to prove that you're learning is good. And basically, they just wanted that as far as learning goes, like in its picky emphasis in the year. Spoken about over there, that the by two, that the bench should element to Shnaim Shiration, and the bench writes it, and because the bench comes and listens to and is going. And whatever it is. So what do you learn from there? But then that if you learn about that, because we learn with two people, they have to talk to each other. By talking to each other, they automatically the Benjamin hears, so they writes it down. The other way, a person sits and learns by himself, he thinks. By thinking, the Benjamin doesn't write that down. It's the full stop, it's not written down. So learn about that. Which is a good mind. It's brought down as a daven ton. You should speak out the words. Why? Because you have two senses working, your work and your hearing. You hear what you're saying. So you have already a chazor of two of your senses. And therefore it has a bigger impression on you than if you just think about it. So therefore it's important. Right? But it's the bigger thing that those shivas that tell you to say. When you have a chavrusa, you know, we're always looking about tupu chaveir. So the bigger an elam is, you think there's going to be a bigger tupu chaveirim. You find out it's not necessarily so. In such a packed place, you can only talk to the two guys next to you because you can't move and stuff like that. And then you can be in a place where that's who's learning. You have to learn the tupu chaveirim with one other person. So used to say, very few people do this. But it's a big difference that the chavrusa should prepare the more on their own, and then learn together. And that way, there's going to be so many disagreements in the thing there that you're going to have to chaveir. Like this, the normal chavrusa, one says, one listens. All you have is one person talking. The other guy is, unless he made a real big mistake, the guy who listens is gonna agree because he's the dominant chavrusa. But if we both already prepared and we see that you learn different than me, I'm gonna make a statement. Why'd you learn like that? And so on. Then you take care of all the shlitas like that. That's how you're gonna grow. Anyway, you're going out now to have ashpoya on people. The ashpoya, you always have ashpoya, but now there are rabbis. It's a rabbi ashpoya, it's a different ashpoya. People look up to you for sure to see what you're doing. So, first of all, you have to make sure that whenever you're saying something now, it's going to be Shem Zayizuch. In other words, no Shemorim in there. You don't give a guy answer to people, and he doesn't know what you're talking about, and then you got to try and explain it to him. Because you explain it to him, you drop out a couple of points, and wherever you go there. So that you're taking out the Shemorim. Sometimes it doesn't work. Don't let the Shemorim go in to start with. That's the way you're supposed to go over the Torah. Clear to the point. And the second thing is that you have to be shaleva so you'll be allowed. You have to work on your talmidim that they should be able to take over and to create themselves, not just take your fire. Hatzlocha to everyone, lies in Zecher Zayin, to Bisco, Tzarek, and Heira.
There are some other people who were involved besides the Torah that we learned the Kollel, but I think it's also Torah. We had Rabbanim and Mechanachim that came to help us with life skills and things that are needed in today's world with how to deal with people and how to deliver our Torah to people. And some of the Rabbanim also came to help us with the learning itself. So this is a shorter list than it should be, but I have to thank Rabbi Webster, Rabbi Petwersky, Rabbi Kaufman, Rabbi Gutman, Mr. Rabbi Shulman, Rabbi Shachrin from the Aguda, Dr. Lindsay Petwersky, Rabbi Ezra Max, Mr. Seth Feldman, and of course, Rabbi Artis, Rabbi Gewurz, the past examples for us. So they are all people who helped us along the way. They have to be mentioned before any snooker can be given. In addition, we all recognize that we learned this the right way, and you should remember that it's not just through Shulchan Aruch. You use the Shulchan Aruch as a Chazorah. You go back and the Shiva said you have to really understand and you give it over clearly. Without the Shmorim, don't put the Shmorim in the first place. But you still have to remember the whole thing, and I'm going to read you the Aruch HaShulchan before we start. The V'yoshiyesh L'daktik V'daris Halalu O'yisim Shemarin Alokh Mitecha Shulchan Aruch V'einam Yerim Tamayinian Shulchan Dabar. People who pass it from Shulchan Aruch, and they don't know the reasons, and when Yadak Mitchila B'Techa Talmud, the Torah is not a very awesome, they're making a mistake. Yesh Ligra B'Hem. You could yell at them. So, we know that Beis Yosef, when he wrote Shulchan Aruch, Mitecha from the Beis Yosef, Asach Hibur, Shekhar, Shulchan Aruch, learn the Skavim Ne'Oilim Lahiris Mitech Sifre Chalima. That's not the point, it's Chazorah. You must remember the Sugya. Go back and you chazer, learn the Gemara over chazer, chazer, chazer is the most important thing. There, now I've discharged my obligations of what I need to tell you before any snicha can be given. And now with Hashem, we're going to be giving out the snickers.